So the other day I put up a program called Density Altitude, and it did really well, and it seemed to be really popular, and it got a lot of views, and it seemed to really strike a chord with a lot of people. So I packed up my little plane and I flew from Washington, D.C. to go visit a friend in Charlotte, North Carolina, right outside of Charlotte, and I flew into Lake Norman. And it was a really hot summer day, and I left in the morning, and I did my weight and balance calculations because I was carrying down some computer equipment for my friend and some other equipment, so the plane was loaded with some stuff. So I made sure all my calculations were good, and as I came into Lake Norman, this is what greeted me. Look at these trees right at the end of the runway, and they are high, and they're really close to the end of the runway. So I kind of came in, and then after I passed the trees, you see, I just kind of dipped right down, and I will leave the landing in because it was an awesome landing. But as I was on the rollout, I was thinking, wow, getting out of here is gonna be a little bit tricky. And as I was also on the rollout, I realized that the runway was going uphill. So I had a lot to think about. So as I was down there for the weekend, I started reviewing some of the comments on the first Density Altitude program, and a viewer sent me a really cool Density Altitude chart. I believe it's called the Koch chart. It's K-O-C-H, and it's on takeofflanding.com. And he said, hey, have you checked this out? So I went to the site, and sure enough, I was really impressed. I thought, this is really cool. And I really needed this because I am gonna really have to do all my takeoff calculations down to the last foot to make sure I can clear these trees. So what you do is, in the upper left-hand corner, is you enter in all the information, your pressure altitude, the temperature, and the runway length. And then if you enter in the identifier of the airport right there, it will automatically bring up the weather and it will load the information for you. And then down here on the right, it will give you the amount percentage to add to your takeoff distance and your decrease in your rate of climb. This was really helpful because I had a bit of a challenging takeoff. Now, I know I'd make it and I know I'd clear it, and other aircraft were clearing it and it was fine, but I really wanted to be down to the actual inch on these calculations just to see what would happen and to see if it was really accurate. So I entered in all the information and I found out that I would need 2,100 feet to take my airplane off to clear it over a 50-foot obstacle, which were certainly those trees at the end of the runway. 2,100 feet. That I had to stop and really think about, because that is over twice the normal takeoff distance in my airplane on a standard day. And that is how much density altitude affects your takeoff performance. So stop and think about that for a second. Over twice the normal takeoff roll. Yeah, that's a lot. And the runway was actually going downhill, so I did pick up speed. And then the one thing I did, which was from another viewer's comment, which I was really thankful for, is I stayed in ground effect a little bit. I stayed in there for maybe, I don't know, maybe 8 seconds, and my speed really picked up, and that was really comforting. So on the takeoff roll, I stayed in ground effect, and then boom, I just popped over those trees and climbed right out. So I want to share this with you. Check out this chart. It's called the KOCH chart, and you can just Google it, and it's on takeofflanding.com. And remember, check your density altitude. It's really important, and thank you so much for watching, and thanks for subscribing. Click that subscribe button, click that notification button if you want to get notified every time we put a new video up here, and thanks for watching.